In a previous video, which I've linked here and below, I showed you how to install Kali on an Apple M1 computer. However, I had some problems. I couldn't get the display to change. I couldn't get Parallels tools to install properly. But fortunately, a lot of people, including Steve, one of the core developers of Kali, gave me some input and helped me resolve those issues. So I want to share in this video how you can get this installation to work properly. As an example, you can change the display within Kali running on Parallels on an Apple M1 Mac. So as an example, I could change the display as follows and keep that configuration or change it to something else. So it's possible to change the display of your Kali server running within Parallels on an Apple M1 Mac. I'll also show you how you can get Parallels tools installed so that you can copy the config from Kali onto your Mac. So in that example, I copied the configuration from my Kali virtual machine onto my Mac, but you can copy both ways and utilize other options within Parallels tools. It's also possible to get a Wi-Fi adapter connected to Kali. So in this example, I've got an alpha network adapter. I'll connect that to my Apple M1 computer. I'll allow the connection. IWconfig now shows me that I've got a Wi-Fi connection. I'll clear the screen and type sudo Wi-Fi. And what you'll see here is that various Wi-Fi networks are detected. So I'm running Kali within a virtual machine, within Parallels on this Apple M1 Mac. I've got an external alpha adapter connected to the Apple M1 Mac, and I'm able to detect various Wi-Fi networks, and I could launch an attack against those Wi-Fi networks. So once again, in this video, I'm going to show you how to get Kali Linux installed and working within Parallels on an Apple M1 Mac. I'll also show you how to overcome various issues with Parallels tools to get the installation to work properly. Now, before we continue, if you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. Please like this video and click on the bell to get notifications. That really does help me with the YouTube robots. Okay, let's get started. Okay, first piece of software that we need is the Parallels desktop software. I've put a link to this page below this video so that you can download the software. Scroll down and click Try Technical Preview. Now you'll need to create an account or log in to your account. I've already logged in, so I'm going to scroll down and click Download to download the software. Software is about 329 meg in size. While I'm waiting for that to download, I'm going to go to kali.org and click Download. Make sure that you download the software for the Apple M1. And the specific software that we want to download is the Kali Linux ARM 64 installer. It's about 3.2 gig in size. I'm not going to try and run the software off a USB drive, so I'm not going to click Live, and I'm not going to use the Net installer. Okay, so that software is going to take a while to download. So what I've done is I've pre-downloaded the software for this demonstration. So I'll stop the Kali download because I've previously downloaded it. And what I'm going to do is right-click on the Parallels desktop DMG file and click Open to open the software. I'll need to install Parallels and then I'll be able to install the Kali ISO. What I'm going to do is right-click and click Open to install the software. I'm warned that this software was downloaded from the internet. I'm okay with that, so I'm going to click Open to install the Parallels desktop software. Installation is actually quite simple, so I'll go through this very quickly. You do have to give Parallels permissions to certain directories on your computer. And as an example here, I have to put in my administrator password to begin the installation. Okay, software is installed and is starting up. I'm going to close the Parallels desktop installer. The installation assistant now displays on my computer. Now, on your computer, you may have to give the Parallels software permission to your downloads directory and various other permissions, you basically have to give the software permissions to function on your computer. So make sure that you give Parallels the permissions that it requests. In my example, I've previously installed Parallels, so I didn't have to do that. So I'm immediately shown the installation wizard. I'm going to click continue to install the software. Now it's discovered a whole bunch of ISOs that I've previously downloaded. I'm going to manually select the file, go to my downloads directory, and I'm going to specify the ARM installer and click open. Now it's unable to detect the operating system. That's fine. I'm going to click continue. What I'm going to do here is specify Linux. Now, once again, previously when I did the installation, I selected Debian, but that caused problems. So I'm going to specify Ubuntu so I can easily resize my desktop, and I'm going to click OK. I'm going to call this Kali 2021.1 and click create. And there you go. You can see that I can now install Kali. What I'll do is select the graphical installation rather than simply installing the software. So just use your arrow keys to select the installation and then press enter. In my example, I'm going to specify English and click continue. I'm going to specify the location as United States. I'll use American English as my keyboard and click continue. Components are loaded. The network is configured. And I'm now asked to specify the host name. I'll simply specify that as Kali. Domain I'll leave as local domain. My username I'm going to specify as Kali, so that's fine. Password I'll leave as Kali as well. I'm going to keep this installation very, very simple. You obviously may want to use better passwords than that, but this is just a demonstration, so I'm going to use Kali as my password. Click continue. I'll leave the clock as it is and click continue. It's now detecting disks and partitioning them. I'm going to use the default option, guided, use entire disk, click continue, specify my disk, install all files in one partition. I'm happy with that, so I'm going to click continue. I'm going to write my changes to the disk and click continue. Software is now installed. So as you can see, the installation is actually very simple. Parallels installation isn't very difficult. Kali installation isn't very difficult. Software is now installing, and hopefully in a moment, I'll be able to boot up Kali on this Apple M1. Now, this is really important. You need to specify your desktop environment. Make sure that you select one of the desktop environments. So I'm going to select the default desktop environment. Make sure that you select that option. In my case, I'm going to select the large collection of tools. So default selection plus additional tools. You don't have to do that, but make sure that you select the desktop environment. A lot of people have had problems where they boot up Kali and they don't have a graphical user interface or GUI, and that's because they didn't select that option. So make sure that you select it. Click continue. So as you can see, files are now being retrieved and the software is being installed. Now's the time to go and get a coffee, wait for the installation to complete, and when it's done, we'll hopefully be able to use Kali. Okay, so there you go. The installation has completed. So I'm going to click continue. System reboots, and I can now launch the Kali GUI. I can now log in with my username and password, and there you go. And as an example, I can ping google.com. I can browse to the Kali website. So the software has successfully installed. Now I can change my displays, so I'll search for display, and I could set the resolution to something like 1920 by 1080, and click apply, and then click keep this configuration. And there you go, my resolution has changed. I could set it to something smaller, click apply, keep this configuration. And as you can see, I can adjust the resolution very easily from within Kali. Now, at this point, you've got a fully working Kali installation. You can adjust the screen, you can use the software, but you may want to install the Parallels tools. Now, there are some issues doing this. There are various workarounds. such as copying the software from the CD-ROM to the desktop. I'll show you an alternate method, but I've had a number of issues with this version of Kali. So just be aware that you may have to jump through some hoops to get this working, but I'll show you how I got this working now. So I'm going to select this option here to install the tools. Now notice what they tell us is that you may have problems installing the tools and you can use this command, but I'm going to do it slightly differently. I'm going to click continue. As you can see, I've got a Parallels Tools icon. I'll double click on that. I'll right click on install and open terminal here. So I'm now in the terminal. Ls shows me the software, so I could say sudo install to install the software. Make this slightly bigger. I need to put in my Kali password, but notice I'm told that permission is denied. Now there are multiple ways to solve this. You could copy the files to your desktop and install it that way, but I'll show you an alternate method that someone posted on my previous video. What I'm going to do is type sudo su. I'm now root. I'll clear the screen, but notice I'm root within Kali. I'm going to type cd. I'm going to unmount the CD-ROM. Okay, so I'm told that the target is busy. So on my desktop, I'm going to unmount the volume and click unmount anyway. Go back into my terminal and mount dev sr0 space. Make sure you put a space there. Media CD-ROM. I'm told that that's read-only. That's fine. So CD media, CD-ROM, and then I'm going to type install to install the software. The Parallels installer displays. I'm going to press enter to go to the next screen. Press enter again to install the software. Press enter again. Okay, so an error is displaying. I'm going to exit. I'm going to run apt update to update references. And then I'm going to type apt install Linux headers 5.10.0 ARM64. Say yes to install the software. Apt install DKMS. And apt install So to try and fix this, I'm going to do an apt update to update my references, and then I'm going to do an apt upgrade to upgrade the software. Various software is now being upgraded. This is another good time to go and get a coffee. Okay, so we've upgraded the operating system. What I'll do is reboot the server. Log in. Okay, so I'll open up Parallels Tools. Go to the installation directory. Ls shows me my software, so I'll try and install it again using sudo. Having the same problem once again, so sudo su. Unmount the CD-ROM, that doesn't work. So I'll do it here. I'll mount it again. Make sure I'm in the right directory and try and install the software again. Install the software and hopefully now it'll install the missing components. Software is being installed. And there you go, the software has installed. So I'll reboot Parallels and start up the virtual machine. I can log in. And hopefully what I'll be able to do is write some text on a Mac. So this is on my Mac, so text on Mac, copy that, go into Kali and paste from the clipboard, and there you go. So that's obviously not a valid command. But what I could do as an example is type iwconfig. No Wi-Fi adapter is found. So what I'll do again is connect my Wi-Fi adapter. I need to make sure I connect it to Kali rather than my Mac. I'm going to allow it to connect. iwconfig. There you go. I've got my Wi-Fi adapter. And what I'll be able to do is copy that. On my text editor, on my Mac, I can paste that output. So I'm able to copy and paste from Mac onto Kali and Kali onto my Mac. I can once again change my display size directly from within Kali. So set it to something like that. And there you go, display has been resized. Okay, so that video turned out to be a lot longer than I anticipated, but hopefully it helps you resolve some of the issues within Kali, specifically with Parallels. Really want to thank Steve and others who have helped me fix various issues within Kali to get this working. Now, if you enjoyed this video, please like it. Please consider subscribing to my YouTube channel and clicking on the bell to get notifications. That really does help me. I'm David Bomble. I want to wish you all the very best.